December 1 is the big day when voting will happen for the municipal elections in Hyderabad. And I have with me Mr. K.T. Rama Rao, Municipal Administration Minister, on whose shoulders the Telangana Rashtra Samiti's campaign for the municipal elections in a sense is happening. The last time round you had 99 out of the 150 wards in Hyderabad. And yet, in many senses, the BJP, which just got 4, seems to be putting you on the defensive.
Well, I don't think so, because you know, they are a party in power in Delhi. And while we've been in Hyderabad, you know, with the blessings of people for the last 6 years in government here, they've also been in power in Delhi for the last 6 years. So therefore, I have every right to question them. I have every right to ask them as to what they've done for Hyderabad in the last 6 years and what they will be doing if voted to power in GHMC. So that's why you see a bit of a tit-for-tat kind of a battle here, but there's nothing particular that I have against BJP.
There's been a lot of action-packed kind of campaign, both from your side and from the BJP side. Congress doesn't even find a mention. I know you have said MIM is your main rival, but it doesn't appear to be so from your kind of campaign speeches and the content.
Well, it's like this. You know, last time, if you look at the numbers, we won 99 and MIM won, I think, 44. And the rest of them won 1, 2 and 4. So therefore, MIM will remain our principal rival because they, you know, stand, you know, number two in the last, they stood number two in the last election. And this time around, if you look at it, there are a lot of seats where we contest directly either with BJP or MIM or Congress. So therefore, depending on where you're speaking, the opponent keeps changing, and that's that, therefore my rhetoric as well.
In many senses, civic issues have been not the main focus of this particular election. And you've been talking about keeping a peaceful Hyderabad. The kind of speeches that have been made, you have objected to them, the BJP's own speeches. Yesterday, they spoke about surgical strikes in Hyderabad. Why wouldn't the government, or the police rather, initiate cases in those kind of cases where you're saying it's inciting communal passion?
Well, BJP's strategy has always been to provoke, get a few cases filed, and then also make it a poll issue again, try and seek sympathy. So therefore, we will answer them in a way that they will understand, and people also will understand, and we will expose them in front of the people. Because if you think about it, last 6 years, I've been asking this one question repeatedly. I've been explaining to people as to what I've done in Hyderabad, what we have done in Hyderabad. As a municipal minister, what have I done? And I've been saying, you know, I've been able to do so much, but if you give me another opportunity, I'll be able to do more. Whereas BJP, on the other hand, I've been asking them repeatedly as to what their government in Delhi, NDA, has contributed to Hyderabad. So far, they've not been forthcoming, and they've only been focused on stoking primordial emotions and passions. So we have every right to question them, ask them some pertinent questions. And I hope at least the next few days, when we have all the bigwigs from Delhi coming in, I hope at least they'll have the answers to the questions we're asking.
Why has this become such a high-stakes election? Was it, in a sense, politically imprudent on your part to have, should I say, helped the decimation or the vanishing of the Congress? It doesn't even find any mention anywhere. And well, you did allow the migration of those MLAs, and did you create a political space that the BJP very clearly is saying this is our stepping stone to the assembly and more role in the South?
It's for the Congress to introspect as to why they are where they are. That's not for me to comment. But at the same time, I think we have to fight somebody. I mean, there will be some opponent who's going to rally with the anti sort of TRS, the people who do not possibly want to vote for TRS. So therefore, I don't find it anything unnatural. It is natural that somebody will emerge and somebody will challenge us, and in this case it is BJP. So I don't think it's anything out of the ordinary or unnatural. But the Congress itself has to introspect as to why it is where it is. So I have nothing more to say about Congress.
The BJP has been saying that voting for your party means a family being promoted. And he's saying the same about the OBC family as well. What is your reaction to that?
Well, today if you look around the country, I mean, yes, it is easy to say certain things and get away with it. But is the BJP above it? Does the BJP not have a lot of people, who belong to their kith and kin of their leaders? For example, in Karnataka, you see Mr. Yediyurappa's son being elected to parliament. You in Madhya Pradesh, you have Srimati Vasundhara Raje Sindhya, Ishodhara and Vijay Raje, and now Jyotiraditya. In Delhi, you see Maneka Gandhi and Varun Gandhi. In Uttar Pradesh, you see Mr. Rajnath Singh and his son. So the list goes on. Point is, nobody is above this. And if people reject us, I mean, I've entered politics as a leader's son, but end of the day, today I'm a four-time legislator, been elected by the same in the same constituency 4 times in a row. So therefore, I think I've stood my ground, I've done my bit. People are electing me, and nobody should have a problem with that.
MIM has obviously been a friendly party to you. Why are you distancing yourself? Is this only a strategy to kind of
Uma, if you
cut
think about
the
it,
anti-MIM vote and split the anti-MIM vote.
If you think about it, we've supported BJP on several issues in Delhi. Does that mean we are friends? Does that mean we are allies? We've supported them on GST. We've supported them on demonetization. We've supported them in the presidential election, vice presidential election. Does that mean we are allies? No. Even MIM has supported us on some bills. Does that mean they are allies? No. They have extended support. That doesn't make us poll allies. Today, in 150 divisions in Hyderabad, we are fighting in all 150. In fact, the last time around, if you look at it, if you look at the numbers, we defeated MIM in 5 divisions. We nearly defeated them in another 10 divisions. So this time, like I said, we will be winning at least 10 to 12 MIM seats. We'll surely make a dent in their bastion, and hopefully we'll continue the same momentum that we have started off about 6 years ago.
The BJP state president has accused you of using, whether the MIM or your party, of using intruder votes to win this election, saying that they are going to have a surgical strike in the Old City area of Hyderabad. What is your own assessment of the numbers there? Rohingyas maybe or illegal?
Well, I think the BJP state president has lost his bearings, because he has to remember that all these people he calls infiltrators have infiltrated directly under the nose of government of India, if they have infiltrated, as he claims, you know. So what was the defense minister doing, and what was the home minister doing, if all his claims are right? So my point is, to accuse people, to say nasty things about people is the easiest thing in the world for anybody to do. To stoke, like I said, primordial emotions and hatred is the easiest thing to do. But the question that one needs to ask oneself is, if these infiltrations are accurate, as you call it, then what has been happening in the last 6 years under the NDA rule? Your defense minister, your home minister, who's giving them Aadhaar cards? Is it the state government or you? Or who's allowed them to infiltrate, as you keep saying? So it's a shame that a person without any comprehension is leading the BJP in Telangana today. And I hope at least now that he realizes what he said and how poorly that reflects on his leaders in Delhi.
The BJP MP from Bengaluru also spoke about a kind of a migration from the Old City area of Hindus out of there. Is there a ghettoization happening, and what are your own figures reflecting? Are people living together, or has there really been such a movement?
Well, BJP MP from Bangalore should focus in Bangalore. There are a hell lot of problems in Bangalore that he needs to take care of. We'll take care
He's
of
also
Hyderabad.
The national president of the Yuva Mocha.
Let him be whatever he is, but the point I'm trying to make is there are enough problems in Bangalore for him to take care of. We will take care of Hyderabad. We have enough people, and we have enough capable leaders here to take care of Hyderabad.
As the state leader, do you see any kind of that kind of a movement where communities are not living together?
Uma, this city has evolved over 430 years. The city was ruled by Nizams at some point, you know, Nizams and Asaf Zahis and Qutub Shahis at some point. So yes, we are proud of our Ganga Jamuna Tehzeeb. We are proud of the religious harmony that exists here, communal harmony that exists here, and the peace that prevails here. If somebody tries to disturb it, without a question, we will certainly take them to task, and we will certainly expose them to the public. So if people talk about things which only stoke hatred, I will not get into that argument. I will not enter into a debate with them. And they should remember, all these people who talk about, all these immigrants, infiltrators, etc., etc., they should remember that it is their government in Delhi, right under whose nose, if whatever their allegations are, if they are true, is happening right under your nose. So please set your home in order.
The 10,000 rupees flood relief that you had announced, did that in a sense become an embarrassment for you?
Absolutely not.
Because of the allegations that came about, protests that came about?
Uma, in a democracy, it's easy to criticize, easy to heckle, easy to punch holes, but it is difficult to deliver. So we as a state, with a very humanitarian approach, have delivered to 6.5 lakh people and a sum of 650 crores. Some people may not have received it. We will deliver after the 4th of December. And if there are some allegations, we will definitely probe into, we will definitely look into them. It's our responsibility. But the question is, how come government of India doesn't respond to our pleas? In Bangalore, when there are floods, in Karnataka, when there are floods, you respond to the chief minister on the fourth day and you deliver 669 crores. In Gujarat, you deliver probably on the second day 500 crores. Is Telangana not a part of India? Is Hyderabad not a part of India? Do you not have the responsibility as government of India to also help, you know, people in distress in Hyderabad? They don't do that, and then they start complaining about what went wrong in what the state government has done. So therefore, this is absolute hypocrisy, and nothing more than that.
The disinvestment of the PSUs that is also not directly related to the municipal elections, but that's something that the chief minister has spoken about, and you have spoken about too.
Well, they are talking about Bin Laden, Babur, and Akbar. in municipal elections. So I think we have every right to talk about everything that went wrong in NDA government's regime, especially on economy. Umar, remember that today we are in a recession. 8 consecutive quarters of slowdown eventually has landed in a lockdown, which now has converted itself into a recession, a full-blown recession. Now, we have to remind people as to what is happening in this country because of the bankrupt economic policy of the people in Delhi. And it's our bounden right to also talk about how PSUs, you know, today when you talk about Air India, they claim that Air India is in losses, so they are selling it. But why are you selling LIC? No answer to that. LIC is in profits. So that's why we are saying Modi government has come out with a new policy. They talked about clean India, they talked about digital India, now they are talking about Becho India. That's why we are saying Socho India. Kya ho raha
hai? Asaduddin Owaisi yesterday said, you know, the lockdown itself was wrong because it made the economy go for a spin and jobs were lost. But your government has very proactively supported the center on many issues.
You know, we have supported several things. In fact, we've supported demonet, we've supported GST, we've supported lockdown. But the fact is, today, in fact, if you look back, has it hurt the economy? Has it helped the economy? Certainly has hurt the economy. Lakhs of people have lost jobs. In fact, Modi Saab, if I remember correctly, had promised 2 crore jobs every year. But it's been 6 years now. I don't know if 12 crore jobs were generated, but I know for a fact that many crores of jobs have been lost because of this reckless, you know, economic policy of this government. So therefore, it is our right, it is our fundamental duty to remind people of what this government has done, what they have perpetrated on the people of this country, and how that has led to unemployment.
Political meetings in the run-up to this election, including your own, are hugely crowded. And that is actually adding to the COVID pandemic. Does that worry you? And I must add to that, the figures that the government is putting out about at least 3.4 million COVID cases that never got reported. And Telangana has only done about 17% RT-PCR, which really means that you have a huge amount of antigen tests, which may not reflect at all the truth.
Well, last 10 days, I've been busy with GHMC, Uma. You have to ask the health minister about the percentages and the numbers. But I can tell you one thing for sure. If a Bihar election can happen, you know, without much of a problem, and if rallies can be held there, and if Prime Minister himself can address rallies there, I don't see any reason why a local election cannot happen in Hyderabad.
The public meetings don't worry you with all the social distancing
completely?
Like I said,
if the Prime Minister is leading from the front all the way from Delhi, and if he can address rallies in Bihar, pre and post elections, I don't see any reason why we cannot have a local body election in Hyderabad.
So what are you looking forward at on the 1st of December? Voting percentages in Hyderabad have been traditionally
very poor.
They've
been abysmal, in fact. They've been abysmal in Hyderabad, and I'm I'm not happy with the fact that the urban denizens don't seem to take elections very seriously. Hyderabad, I request you, I urge you, please come out and vote. Vote for progress, vote for decisive politics, vote for people who can take your city forward, and most certainly that is us, so please vote for us.
Okay, thank you so much. So, KT Ramarao once again batting on the front foot and hoping perhaps that he is going to better the 99 mark that they made the last time round. In Hyderabad, with camera person Nagraju, Uma Sudhir, NDTV.